The following is a presentation of HEW Entertainment on their official website and a broadcast on social media. Listener's discretion is advised.
It's that time once again for HEW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
The Beat! The Man!
You gotta beat the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 372928. If you're from Canada and would like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 372928. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/HEW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us HEWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god. J-B-L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of HEW Entertainment Radio on the official website of HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
HEW Entertainment Radio is inviting you to comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us. So what are you waiting for? Log on and listen now.
Don't miss out on any of the action. Download our app on the App Store, Google Play, and the official website of HEW Entertainment. Once you've downloaded and installed it, you'll get caught up on news, YouTube videos, and more. Download it now.
When I met you in the summer, to my heartbeat sound, we fell in love as the leaves turned brown. And we could be together, baby, as long as skies are blue. You act so innocent now, but you lied so soon. When I met you in the summer,
summer.
With over 50,000 views on our YouTube channel, this is HEW Entertainment Radio with Calvin Harris's hit from last summer. It's called Summer, and what a great summer it was. 19 of the 31 days in July above 25 degrees, and August was pretty amazing, too. We're still breaking records from this past summer, a little over 6 days into the month of September, approaching the fall of the year, and it's hard to believe we're still breaking records from this past summer. It's amazing when you really sit back and put it into perspective how much the rest of the world can envy Canada right now for how great temperatures we've been having and how great of a summer we've just put behind us. You can join the conversation with us on social media. I, of course, am your host, Jonathan Clark, taking you through another video blog distribution on our YouTube channel this week. This time, really frustrated on Kane and the direction of his character. He's back to being the director of operations in the WWE, and I'm sure I'm not the only wrestling fan who is frustrated with this. They were going to go with the Demon Kane angle with Daniel Bryan before Daniel Bryan forfeited the title due to injury, and it seemed to be that Kane was going to be the one designated to be champion and pick up the ball where Daniel Bryan dropped it because of his injury a little over a month after winning the title at WrestleMania 30 earlier this year. And now Kane has gone back to being the director of operations and representing the authority and handling Triple H and Stephanie's dirty work when they don't want to, as the suited Kane, the corporate Kane, which he was back in 1999, early thousands. To me, the original corporate Kane was far more impressive and far more interesting of a character than this new revamped version of the new corporate Kane. How do you feel about it, and what kind of direction do you think Kane's character is headed in? You can get in on the conversation in our forum on our website and let us know, and by leaving it for us in the comments of this video blog. I'm more pissed off than I am happy for Kane's character. I don't know why WWE keep putting over Kane as the director of operations. The only logical explanation I can come up with is because of an injury that Kane may be suffering from. They're keeping him out of the ring, so to give him a job as a general manager kind of character is just kind of keeping him on WWE television, because they know now the Undertaker streak just came to an end this year. At WrestleMania, there's a chance we may never see the Undertaker again, and if we do see the Undertaker again, it'll be to be inducted into the Hall of Fame. So they have to keep an Undertaker kind of character on WWE television. So by keeping him out of the ring and having him be in the role of like a general manager under a different job title while Kane recuperates from an injury is probably their excuse just to have him on television. But I really hate how he comes out and cuts these pointless promos that have nothing to do with his character and are just putting over Stephanie and Triple H. They can get anybody to put over themselves. They don't have to have Kane be their lapdog, which is pretty much what Kane is demoted to after all these years of establishing a legacy in professional wrestling. He's a former world champion, and he's gone from being a former world champion to a lapdog and a bitch of Triple H and Stephanie. And I really do apologize for my choice of words towards Kane's character, but really, is there any other way of describing what they're doing with Kane's character? They really lost a sense of direction for the Kane character in WWE, and I really appreciated the Demon Kane in 2012 when he returned as the revamped version of the Kane character, the original Masked Kane, and it seemed like they were really going to run with him, and they went from having him be the Masked Kane to being the director of operations back to the Masked Kane. Again, I appreciated the decision to have him put the mask back on. Obviously, it was just to give Daniel Bryan an excuse to defend the championship against someone he had a lot of history with, to kind of build a character and an excuse for Daniel Bryan to keep winning and overriding the authority after WrestleMania to continue riding on his wave of momentum he's had since coming out of WrestleMania. And now that Daniel Bryan is gone, the only thing they have left for Kane to do is go back to square one and be the director of operations in WWE. And the thing is, Kane isn't always in that role every week on Raw and SmackDown. He's just there when he's required to be there, when Stephanie and Triple H can't make a booking in WWE for a house show or a television taping. Kane just kind of comes in and fills the vacancy that's left behind Triple H and Stephanie in their wake. It's just terrible what they're doing with Kane's character, and I don't see him getting out of this debacle anytime soon. And I really feel for the Kane fans that are out there, and believe me when I tell you, there are thousands, if not millions, of Kane fans out there that really enjoy seeing Kane on television and even appreciate him more when he's challenging for the championship. And the good thing about the Demon Kane, when they took him back to being the Demon Kane after having him be the director of operations from the first time they cut that, the thing was Kane was challenging for the championship. So Kane fans learned to appreciate Kane a lot more than what they originally had. I myself included. I wanted to see Kane eventually win the WWE Championship, and if there ever was a candidate to take the title away from Daniel Bryan, it would have been Kane because of the momentum that he had after the feud with Daniel Bryan picked up where they left off
when they were former tag team champions. Remember the team Hell No and how much history they had, former tag team champions, and how popular they were with the WWE Universe. They chose the name for them. They really didn't agree with the fans' choice of having them be a team and the team name they chose, but they quickly became one of the most popular teams in WWE, and it really seemed like they were going to run, with Kane being the demon, not really appreciating the fact that Daniel Bryan was the one who had originally won the title over someone like Kane. But now it's just like Kane is just kind of sitting in the corner waiting to explode. He's waiting to implode and kind of suffer from spontaneous combustion, in my opinion. Spontaneous combustion seems to be where Kane is headed right now, because there's really nothing